Hey guys, in this video, I'll be sharing three lessons that I learned from reading the book Principles by Ray Dalio. And he's an American founder of Bridgewater, which is one of the largest hedge funds. I myself, my net worth is probably a few tens of thousands of dollars, but this guy is a billionaire, so I figured that there will be some interesting things to learn from him. More to what this video is about, it's more of a selfish attempt to force myself to better internalize the lessons that I learned from these books, because sometimes when I read such books, it comes in one ear and goes out the other ear, and this will be part of my attempt to force myself and teach others digitally through video as well. The first lesson that I learned from reading the first half of the book, because I haven't finished the whole book, is that he is extremely open-minded, and one principle that he often champions is called radical open-mindedness. Think about it, he is a billionaire, and repeatedly throughout the book, he always mentions that there is always a possibility that one's decision might be wrong. And no matter how far you are in life, whether if you are a billionaire or even worth tens of thousands of dollars like me, you need to put your ego down. So I always thought that I already had a small ego, but when I read this book, right, I realized I really had quite a big ego in a sense. And one quote that he often mentions in the book is that always be obsessed about finding the right answer, and the right answer does not necessarily have to come from you. And one thing that he often talks about in the book is to triangulate your opinion with other smart people who have high believability rates, in a sense whereby you want to talk and stress test your opinions out there with other people and not let the opinions sink in your head to think that it's the best option, because the decision that lies in your mind, or at least the opinion that lies in your mind, it may be the best thing to you, but it's not the best answer. And through talking with other people, being radically open-minded about exchanging thoughts with other smart people, that brings out the best answer, which might not necessarily come from you. The second thing that I learned from reading the book is that he mentions the concept of amygdala versus the prefrontal cortex. So the amygdala is a part of our brain which is a more instinctual part of the brain, whereby it goes for pleasure and it avoids any kind of pain, whereas prefrontal cortex is extremely logical. It plans out all your goals, in a sense. So I'm sure there's always some part of our lives where we are looking at that delicious cake and we were talking to ourselves that we shouldn't eat it because it's not healthy. Your prefrontal cortex makes logic clear for you, in a sense whereby eating this cake will make you gain calories, it's full of sugar, it will make your brain feel foggy and groggy, and you won't be able to think clearly for the next few days. The impression that I get of the decisions that you make through your prefrontal cortex is much better, and that's why I need to remind myself of that. Third lesson that I learned from reading this book is about the concept of first, second order, and third order consequences. I'll just use back the example that I used earlier, which is eating a cake. We know that eating a cake is very nice. It provides very good first order consequences, in a sense whereby we feel pleasure from it. The cake is very delicious. It satisfies our sugary sweet tooth needs. But then the second order consequences is that in the long run, we might have diabetes from that, and that is not a very good thing to have. I've always been succumbing to my first order consequences recently, whether it's eating ice cream or not exercising or not doing my 6x400 meter interval, which I'm trying to improve my running on right now. And that's why I want to be able to better internalize such message, to not succumb to my first order consequences. So that's it for the three lessons that I learned from reading the first half of this book. I hope this video was helpful in some way, whether you want to take this up, or if reading is not your thing, then perhaps you could just watch this video. I guess that's it for this video. I just want to say thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, and see you in the next one.